Stocks may have staged a comeback for today, but long term, the charts are mimicking a pattern that is much more disturbing, or so says our next guest. Tom DeMark is the CEO of DeMark Analytics. Tom, great to have you on the program.
Great to be with you.
You've got three charts to walk us through. Why don't you kick it off with your first one?
Sure. The first chart shows you the price activity of Dow Jones average into the bottom in spring of 1980, and the similarity between the current market and what occurred in 1980. That was the bunker hunt low. I remember that period very well. Everyone thought that the exchanges were going to close permanently at that time. The pessimism was so thick that the market just, we knew it had the bottom at that time. Otherwise, the prospects wouldn't look good for the economy or politically. So
right.
That's the first chart. The second chart is, see, what we're trying to do is compare the current market with prior periods. And what we did, we identified three, this is months ago, we came up with three comparisons that were pretty closely correlated. The second one is the 2007-2008 decline, and we were able to play this almost step-by-step, percentage-wise, throughout the entire decline. People who followed us at that time did remark how well it was correlated. Now, the third chart, which is the most important, and that's what's influenced me just recently, that particular chart, we followed and we're looking at it now. I've compared the current market with what occurred in through the period of August 9th through October 3rd of 2011, and they look similar. We've got these marked with ones and twos and ABCs, and but they do relate to successive or consecutive up and down closes. And this has influenced me, like I said, despite the fact that the Chinese markets, on the days of the low, we identified the bottoms recently. We identified the January 20th and the February 11th low with an intervening high on February 1st. We were able to get the exact highs and lows, and we're really going against what some of our work is telling us. 90% of our indicators have identified the low as February 11th, but there are 10% of the indicators that are still saying we have to go down one more time. We've got crude oil. When we were on the air February 11th, we identified that as the bottom, and the market did rally. We expected 40%. Ultimately, we should see that, but we are going to see a test of that low. I think intraday we're going to go below the February 11th low, and at that time we thought it was upcoming this week, possibly. We thought the stock market could unravel. Mm-hmm. We could see a sharp decline. We still think we're going to see it. Yesterday, we got what we call price flip downside, but it was just isolated to the S&P average. The broad indices did not have that same price flip, and we expect them to top in 2 days. So we want to reassess everything on Friday, and we think the market could still get hit.
So Friday is going to be a critical day. Let's say in the worst-case scenario on Friday, Tom, what's the downside in your view?
Well, the downside we've had for some weeks has been 1783, 1790, in that area, and that influenced us at the low. When we turned positive on February 11th, we said we didn't quite hit the price objective. Normally, our timing model is consistent with the price objective. It wasn't at that time, and that's what also influenced us to think that we are going to see one more decline. I think today was just an overreaction. There was some news that we predicted the market would decline Monday, you know, the top would be made Monday, and it just hasn't unfolded the way expected. At the we declined to 1888.80, and that was our downside projection for a rally, and that's what we saw today. So we got to, I think what we'll see is the broad indices, IWM, the Russell, the small cap and mid cap make new highs above the recent highs, and that would set up everything for one more attempt to break, and hopefully we do break.